The last grammar topic for this week will be dangling modifiers, also known as misplaced modifiers. You may recall that a modifier is a word or phrase that clarifies, limits, or modifies a verb or noun. Often this is an adverb or an adjective. Either way, though, it's something that either makes your verb or noun more specific or is limiting it to some specific attribute, or it might be adding some information to it. So in the example I've given here, the sentence says, the scientists sampled the stream quickly running down the slope. If I say this to you in everyday language, you probably would assume that it is the stream quickly running down the slope. But in technical writing, we need to be explicit. So who's quick, or what is quick, and who is running, or what is running? Are the scientists quickly running down the slope, or is the stream quickly running down the slope? It's actually impossible to tell from the sentence which is which, and we don't want to make the reader assume one or the other, even if it's fairly obvious like this sentence is. So I've corrected this in three different ways, and you can see that each sentence means something slightly different. The first sentence says, the scientists quickly sampled the stream that was running down the slope. In this case, the stream is running and the scientists were quick. In the second sentence, the scientists sampled the stream that was running quickly down the slope. This is probably what you assumed the incorrect sentence to mean in the first place. The stream is both running and quick. And in the third sentence, the scientists sampled the stream while they ran quickly down the slope. In this case, the scientists are both quick and running, while the stream is just being there. So depending on what you mean, you need to be very specific about where you place the modifier. In the next example, we have a subject that is not mentioned, so it's inferred or assumed. And in this case, the sentence reads, having identified the mineral, the gemstone was placed in the museum. If you read this literally, you might think that the gemstone identified the mineral. But knowing how this works, you probably assumed that some geologist had identified the mineral and then placed the gemstone in the museum. So that's how we should write our sentence. Having identified the mineral, the geologist placed the gemstone in the museum. Or, the gemstone was placed in the museum after its minerals were identified. And you can see here that we're using the passive voice. We're going to talk a lot more about using active voice because that can also help get rid of dangling modifiers. So as this is the last topic for the week, make sure you've read all the links. And once you're finished reading the links and watching the videos and listening to the podcasts about these topics, you can go on and write the quiz. And as a reminder, because this is the first week, make sure that you write the quiz before the following week. And we'll be doing that once a week. And each of these quizzes or assignments is worth 2.5% of your overall mark. Okay, thanks, and we'll talk to you next week.